Hi folks, welcome to the RV Corral. I'd like to take a few minutes of your time to show you a nice new trailer that we have available here. It's a Keystone Cougar model. It's a 21 foot, really nice little trailer. Got a great floor plan. It's a lighter weight. This is considered a half ton series trailer, so it's not a heavy unit. This is something you could pull with either a smaller truck or an SUV. Great design. These, by the way, are made in locally here. This is their half-ton series they build here in Pendleton, Oregon, so it's manufactured here in Oregon. It makes it nice to have the manufacturing facility here close by, so it's easy to get parts, and you know everything doesn't have to be shipped so far. Like some of the manufacturers tend to be a little bit further away. Also nice to be able to support local businesses and workers that work here in our own state. It's a great product line. We carry four Keystone lines. We like this company a lot. They offer a lot for the money. This is a well-built quality trailer. It's not entry-level quality. This is a little nicer trailer. You know, maybe you're looking to upgrade a little bit. You've got a nice older trailer now. You're thinking about getting something newer or maybe brand new. This could be a good opportunity for you and still stay in a smaller unit. Does come with two propane tanks up front here. We'll make sure you have two batteries. We'll have two brand new batteries. We even fill your propane tanks to make sure that you got plenty of propane to go camping and get you started right off the bat. When you leave, you should be ready to go hit your favorite campsite. You can see here it does have a front Phylon fiberglass cap with the diamond shield plating on down below here to kind of help protect the front end against rock chips and things of that nature. Fiberglass all the way around, and has a one-piece rubber roof on top. Good roof material. I like the way they've designed this now to where you can, it's got a little magnet here, so when you're wanting to get into your pass-through storage, you can just lock that up in the position without having to wrestle with it. Goes all the way across. You can take a look down through here. You can see that your pass-through storage does, it's got a good size pass-through area. Goes all the way across. This is welded aluminum framing, so your side walls, your floor are all welded aluminum. You can kind of see if you look underneath here, if you check out the welds, you can see they're all full welds. They do a nice job of putting these together. They don't spot weld them. I mean, just the quality of the workmanship is great. I like this too, where they've got the slam latch openings on your compartment door too, instead of the little twist knobs. These are a lot better, a lot handier. Comes with a nice size awning. You can see the awning goes almost the whole side of the trailer. It is electric, so it makes it easier to get in and out. You don't have to wrestle with the awning when you want to get it in or out. You can just push the button. It even has a little remote. You can do it from outside here. You don't even have to be inside your trailer to get your awning out. Nice big scare light. Has speakers on the outside also. Outside shower with hot and cold water. It has great suspension system they have with this one's equipped with Correct Track, which is a trailer alignment system. It's a modified, upgraded system that they use to help keep your trailer tracking better, so it's easier to pull, and it's going to be less of a challenge to get it down the road. Even though, you know, this is a pretty easy pulling trailer, every little thing that they can do to make it better just is that much make it your experience that much better. In the back here, you do have your hot water heater. This has a gas electric hot water heater, and it is a fast recovery, so it actually heats up to 16 gallons an hour. So some of your manufacturers might have a bigger hot water heater, like for example, a 10 gallon. This is a 6, but some of the 10 gallon hot water heaters will only heat up to 8 gallons an hour, so they don't recover very quickly. So if you use all the hot water, you have to wait for a while before you get to be able to replace it. With 16 gallons an hour, it recovers fairly quickly, so you'll be able to take longer showers and not have to wait so long to have the next person step in and get showered. Has a ladder on the back here. A nice slide out bumper in the back also. This does have an extendable bumper with a flat surface here for storage. Over on this side, you can see you do have the slide out. Your power cord has a black tank flush here, so you can hook up a hose to this, put pressure to it, and help keep your black tank cleaned out. All your black tank connections are right back here for your to drain your black and gray tanks. So this is kind of the business side. Even has a hookup here for your satellite or cable. Let's take a look inside. Let me show you how this one's laid out. I like this little grab handle here too. This is nice because it's retractable, but it really makes a difference for getting in and out. You might point out too, this does have the polar pack, so this one's equipped with the polar pack, so it has the capability of being more of a all-season type trailer, so you could take it out even when the weather's cold and be comfortable in it. It's all fully enclosed underbelly, so you have heat. And whenever your furnace is on, all your underbelly is all heated, so you'll have heat to your tanks and your water lines, and all that'll be kept nice and warm. So it makes a lot of difference, especially if you like to get out when the weather's not so nice. Come on in. Let's start up front here. As you can see, you have a queen walk-around bed. Storage on each side for clothes, and up above you do have a cabinet up above. There's quite a bit of storage underneath the bed also. I also like the fact that it has what they call a little laundry chute, so this opens up into your pass-through storage that we looked at from outside. So if you needed to get to something that's down in your pass-through storage, you could reach it from right here, or like to say they call it a laundry chute. You could throw things down in there, like dirty laundry, for example. It comes with a flat-screen TV, which is going to be set up right here. This does swivel around, so you can move this TV around, face it either direction, face it out that way, or back towards your bedroom area. Has a DVD player, CD player. Even has an MP3 port, so you can plug in your MP3 player or your iPod. Take a look at the nice big drawers down here too. Full extension guides. They're metal guides. You know, I mentioned this is a 21-foot trailer, but look at all the counter space you have. You don't see that in a smaller trailer very often. They have that kind of kitchen counter space. Even has an extendable countertop right there. Good storage, nice deep cabinets. More drawers over here also. Comes with a microwave oven and your gas oven. It's a 22-inch oven, so it's a little deeper oven. A little more space available in there than some of the smaller ovens. Nice three-burner cook stove with a high-intensity burner up front. Double sinks. They really are set up very nice. This one has a, like I mentioned, does have a slide out with lots of windows in it. You notice too, how big a window they put in these slide outs. You know, a lot of times your slide out windows are going to be small. Some manufacturers just don't believe in putting a big window in your slide out. I'm sure it helps keep the cost down if you don't. And sometimes, and a lot of times actually, they're not windows that will open up, which with the Cougar here, it does have big windows and they'll open up, so you can actually get a good flow of fresh air through here. Almost every window in this trailer actually will open up, so you can utilize the fresh air. And half the fun of getting out is to enjoy the outdoors, right? This has a nice wraparound dinette booth that will make into a bed. So the tabletop will extend down, drop down. You can fill all this area in here with the cushions. Have another bed This will also, it's movable, so you can take it outside if you just choose to do so. More storage underneath your dinette area also. Like I mentioned, you know, just being a 21-foot trailer, this weighs only about 5,500 pounds dry, so it's a pretty light trailer. So you could, you know, pull it with without having to have a big vehicle and yet still have plenty of room. It has a nice gas electric refrigerator, freezer on top separate from your refrigerator down below. That's an 8 cubic feet with the nice wood panel. Control here for your heating and air conditioning. This does have a nice air conditioner. It's a 15,000 watt air conditioner, so, or BTU, so it has a bigger air conditioner. It's an upgraded over the 13.5, which is more typical, kind of standard in a lot of these trailers. Notice the bathroom area too. Nice stand-up shower, porcelain toilet. Put the sink back in here. Really nice little layout. And a lot of storage back in here also. Nice deep cabinet. Place to hang up clothes. And I like the fact that you have the controls right up here too, right by your door, easy to get to. I mentioned something about the remote that you could use to, you know, open your awning out. You can, here it is right here. You can take this out, use this to turn on lights, get your awning out, even can open up your slide out. But your controls are right here on this panel too for those things, for the slide out, for your awning. You can check your tank levels right here, turn on lights. Just a nice handy place to put them. Like I mentioned, it's a great opportunity for somebody if you're looking to upgrade, or maybe this will be your first trailer. You're just thinking you want something fairly small but with a good floor plan, easy to pull. This could be a good opportunity for you. I'd love to tell you a little bit more about it. If you want to know a little bit more, just please get a hold of me. They call me Catfish Jim here at the RV Corral, and it's Jim Beckler. So look me up and I'll be glad to help. Thanks.